As augmented reality is becoming more capable and widespread, more computing power, cheaper price, and just a smaller form factor, there are certain industries and use cases that benefit massively from this. One of those use cases I want to talk about here is AR wayfinding or indoor-outdoor navigation. Again, there are multiple ways how we can call this, but this is a really, really powerful and underutilized opportunity actually for a lot of developers and people in industries working with those large complex spaces.
Whether it's a baseball stadium, a shopping mall, an airport, or industrial plant.
Any of those things, again, if it's complicated to walk around and you can get lost, which is a lot of places, then this technology can be extremely beneficial in saving lots of time, money, and basically just frustration also. And in this video, I want to give you an overview of navigation technology, where and why you can use it, and how you can get started yourself. If you don't know me, my name is Dinesh, and I have been working in this industry for almost a decade now. We work with partners in the XR field like Meta, but also with our enterprise partners who use XR to enhance their businesses. Otherwise, I am a public speaker on this topic. I consult businesses, and also we have a flagship event, our hackathon, the XRCC, which is bringing our top talents of our community and our enterprise partners together to really shape and push what the technology is capable of doing. So what is AR wayfinding and how does it work? First of all, again, there are multiple ways how we can call this AR wayfinding, visual positioning, indoor-outdoor navigation. For the sake of this video, let's just go with AR wayfinding. And also, by the way, it doesn't have to be an AR, but of course, since this is an XR-focused channel, that's kind of the angle we want to take this here. So just a quick recap, AR wayfinding is using augmented reality to navigate inside or outside of large complex spaces. Think of it like using GPS, but in a better way, in places where GPS is just too inaccurate or it's just too complicated to use maps. So basically, you would hold your phone, for example, and you would have real-time navigation instructions, where to go, etc. Instead of a phone, in the future, of course, also or already present, you can also use wearables. So you just have basic glasses where you can just see everything exactly how and where you need to go. And there are lots of other interesting ways how this can be used. And this is some stuff that we'll cover later in this video as well. So the way that it works, very simplified, is that you create a 3D representation by scanning the environment with special cameras, and this then creates a point cloud that you can use. Think of it like a big 3D map of the actual space. The big problem is that it can be really complex and cost intensive to scan your whole environment in an efficient 3D point cloud to be then used for navigation and everything, which leads us to our sponsor of this video, Immersal. Immersal is a company that develops technologies such as spatial mapping and visual positioning, which enables developers to create any sort of AR experience. And the cool thing is this does not have to be only navigation. There are multiple ways how you can use this as well, because you have the raw asset, you have the files, you have the 3D map. And in this video, I will also show how you can use it as well. Otherwise, you can also use it for non-AR use cases such as 2D navigation and asset tracking. And there are a lot of benefits of using the Immersal technology rather than trying to build it yourself. I mean, first of all, good luck building that yourself. The good thing working with them is that you have very accurate device positioning for navigation and visualization. So the first benefit, easier navigation inside and outside large complex spaces, something we briefly touched upon in this video already, but really you provide precise navigation instructions that you kind of like baked in into the physical reality. So whenever you want to go to any place, whether it's a mall, it's a
industrial plant,
it's a venue, like an event venue or something like this. Actually, we should use it for our hackathon. So people don't get lost anywhere. It can be extremely helpful just because you help the user to find those locations much faster, and also you save a ton of frustration. So one interesting way how you can also use it, and I think that it is pretty cool and have not seen too much before, is you can improve the user experience also by having a gamified experience. You can engage the users with some sort of mini game or some scavenger hunt or something like this, where maybe they need to discover the place or they need to find a specific thing, or even having like users sharing things in the space for each other. I don't know, it could be any creative way that comes up your mind. And that is also an interesting way to help your users to get familiar with your space. And I think that is, depending on what kind of large space you have, that can be really interesting also to help them to walk around and like maybe, hey, you have to find this place over here and then this place over here, and then you can see through them or something like this. There are so many creative ways that you can use this to gamify the whole experience. And the cool thing is, since every user is using it on their phone, they can use it on their phone at least, you can also massively personalize it also by having some coupon codes or having some other lead capturing system or some other way. And that can also help you a ton in understanding how your visitor is actually experiencing your space. Maybe there's like a certain hotspot where everybody's getting stuck or something like this, and then you can fix it. So not just by actually making it easier for the visitor, but also for gaining the insights and maybe again gaining some feedback from them, or they map their favorite place or some other way. So there's a lot of interesting gamify experiences that you can definitely try out for this technology. And the third benefit, you can overall improve the operational efficiency. That is also really helpful when you have a lot of workers in your, let's say,
industrial plant,
you know, something like this, where you need them to find specific machines or any sort of assets that may have even moved to some other place, and you want to see also where they are, what they are doing and stuff like this. I think that is, in general, you can get a much better understanding of how your operations are running in terms of people walking through your complex space. So in general, you save time, you optimize the workflows, and you just have a smoother operation in general, having less mistakes also. And one of the more interesting things also that it can be used is this can also be integrated with real-time IoT sensors. And I think that is also where this can be really interesting in improving training and remote assistance. So there's one interesting use case that I would like to talk about, and this is the Mall of Tripler. And the cool thing is, this is not some future idea, this is something actually being used. And I think like with AR and VR in general, the big problem is people talk a lot about the future of this, the future of this, and nothing like concrete. And this is like an actual project that has been developed, and this is something that I would like to share. So Immersal created a pilot indoor navigation project for, it's one of the largest shopping malls in the Nordics. It's called the Mall of Tripler, and it's an 85,000 square meter shopping mall in Helsinki, and they have 250 plus stores. And the Immersal team managed to map three floors of the Tripler mall in less than 2 days, and there was no interruptions or any problems with the operation. So they didn't have to close the whole mall or something like this. They could just do it while everything was running smooth. And that is also really important, that you don't have like a massively overly complicated use case. And now you have a point cloud or this 3D map of this mall, and you can basically use, you can just go there, you can use your phone, you can use it in web AR, or you can use it as an app as well to really find your one of those 250 stores spread out across the whole mall, and really find all of those places and just save a lot of time. If I will be in Helsinki at any time, I will definitely check it out and then let you guys know how it was. But yeah, that is something that again can be applied to pretty much anything. And I think this is kind of where the power of AR comes handy, because I wish I would have this when I go to a freaking concert, like massive concert hall, or especially at the airport. I mean, airports is okay, but sometimes when you go to like a big meetup or like an event, most of the time, I swear, the signs and where you find what is so complicated and you just get lost all the time. And having something like this would always make my life so much easier in figuring out where to go, because there's like so many other stresses already. And I definitely think that this is a actually helpful and good technology making our lives easier. So in this video, I gave you a big picture over view in why and when it can be really interesting and useful to use the immersive technology or AR wayfinding in general, but we didn't talk about how to set it up. The cool thing is, we at Immersive Insiders, we got you covered, because now in this video, we will also show you how you can get started yourself without any previous knowledge. Feel free to check it out. The video is free, of course, so no worries. The technology is really interesting also, and we will have a bunch of tutorials in showing you how to get started. We will have, of course, a basic overview. We will integrate it with other cool tools and then also show you how you can use it in multi-user form and some other cool, interesting cases. So check it out here, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.